Today I have Dr. T.V. Narayana, Director of Vikas Institute of Pharmaceutical Sciences and National President of Indian Pharmaceutical Association. We welcome you here, sir.
Thank you.
So, sir, welcome to the platform where we want to know what are your thoughts on education. So, sir, what is IPA?
Yeah, IPA is Indian Pharmaceutical Association. It is a national professional body of pharmacists engaged in various facets of professional pharmacy, that is industry, regulatory, education, hospital pharmacy, community pharmacy. This organization was established before our independence, 1939. And the first president is known as Father of Pharmacy, M.L. Shroff. And I am the 36th president. The headquarters is at Mumbai. And we have 22 state branches and 60 local branches spread throughout the length and breadth of our country. And IPA advised the government and other organizations on vital professional issues. And being a member of Drug Technical Advisory Board, we advise the government for the approval of the new drugs coming into the market. So we represent over 1 million pharmacists of the country, that is IPA. And this is affiliated to WHO, International Pharmacist Association, Asian Federation of Pharmacist Association, American Association of Indian Pharmacists. And IPA encourages the students, teachers, researchers with various awards and prize money and various activities organized throughout India, throughout the year. It is a vibrant organization, I can say.
Wow, sir, that's wonderful. So, coming back to the our topic for the discussion, being the director of Vikas Institute of Pharmaceutical Sciences, what is your philosophy of leadership and how would you describe your leadership style?
Yeah, this leadership quality cannot be acquired. It should be built in by born. And some type of qualities you can learn from the society and learn from the what you call benchmarkers, bench setters. And you have to identify the problems concerned with that particular profession. Suppose if you are a pharmacist, what are the problems during your student days? And how you are addressing it? And whether the problems you are addressing is going to be benefited to the next generation. That's how you have to look into it. Then only the people will consider you as a leader representing the issues. A simple example, when the pharmacy students after completion of B-Pharma, they want to go for M-Pharma, they have to appear for GATE exam conducted by AICTE. But all of a sudden in the year 2000, AICTE removed GATE exam for pharmacy students and continued with engineering students. Then we addressed that problem, we approached the court and we brought GPAT, that is Graduate Pharmacy Admission Test, that is still continuing. That is how you have to address the issue concerned with the profession, concerned with the students, whether it is going to be beneficial for the next generation. Then they automatically will recognize. This is one example I am telling you. And another this thing is, you have to take the advice of your teachers, which is lagging nowadays. The student-teacher relationship is not seen in nowadays, the system existing nowadays. Earlier, the teacher is the main person who is to guide by looking at the potential of the student. Okay, you are suitable in this area, you are suitable in this area. Okay, you can go for industry, you can go abroad, or you can go research and development. That was the advice given by the teachers. And seniors, those who are well established at various capacities in various areas, walks of life, you can take them as a role model and continue them and try to follow them, and definitely you will be a successful leader of the future. That's what I have did. That is, I am from a small family and completed my అండర్ గ్రాడ్యుయేషన్ అండ్ పోస్ట్ గ్రాడ్యుయేషన్ ఫ్రమ్ ఆంధ్ర యూనివర్సిటీ వేర్ మై టీచర్స్ గైడెడ్ మీ ఓకే డాక్టర్ నారాయణ అట్ టైమ్ ఐఎమ్ నాట్ డాక్టర్ ఐఎమ్ మిస్ నారాయణ యూ వాంట్ టు గో అబ్రాడ్ దిస్ ఇస్ ద ఏరియా యూ హ్యావ్ టు గో లైక్ దిస్ యూ వాంట్ టు గో ఫర్ ఇండస్ట్రీ దిస్ ఇస్ ద ఏరియా దెన్ ఐ కేమ్ ఐ ఫాలోడ్ దేర్ అడ్వైస్ అండ్ ఐ యాడెడ్ మై ఓన్ థింకింగ్ బికాస్ no need to entirely depend on the advice because advice is free in the market anybody can give the advice but how it best fits to you and with your experience you add up your intelligence and your thoughts your thinking then if you work out definitely you will be a successful leader no doubt in it and I started my career as an ordinary member in this Indian Pharmaceutical Association that is 20 years back And I proved myself that the various tasks assigned to me, I did perfectly. So leaders thought, okay, he is our next generation leader. Now I elevated to the position of president. Started from an ordinary member 20 years back. So I became a national president of the prestigious organization. There I also became the president of Southeast Asian region also. That I am the first person from India. And I advise... next generation you have to plan accordingly be honest and be sincere because these are the main areas you have to look into which was lagging nowadays at the present generation and there is no shortcut because there is no shortcut for the success in life once you plan accordingly you are sincere and honest people will start recognizing you and also don't think okay I will get a job of 25000 rupees 30000 rupees I am satisfied with this be a job provider rather than a job seeker that's what I want to advise and I have seen several students across India when I have come across them interacted with them there is some sort of no confidence in them confidence levels are down because where is the finance to start a business to give jobs to others we are having the intention but I will advise them thinking is the capital entrepreneurship is the way hard work is the solution so when I just joined my career as a teacher in the year 1989 when I started working in a private organization I have seen the people with the 10th class qualification or not even 10th class or a BA BCom running the professional colleges they are running the professional colleges when it has given me a serious thought when a non professional person can run a college why can't I that is the ignite in my mind and I succeeded today I am having three institutions in India two in Bangalore one in Rajahmundry Vikas Institute
wonderful sir if somebody can do it then why can't I do it is your mantra offline wow yeah. So sir how does the curriculum of Vikas Institute or pharmaceutical sciences ensure the best practice in the industry?
Yeah, it was a situation in India, the pharmacy curriculum is uniform throughout country. It was regulated by a agent body called Pharmacy Council of India. They designed the syllabus, they designed the curriculum. Earlier, the universities are having the flexibility to tailor-made the syllabus. To modify the syllabus but now the syllabus or curriculum cannot be modified it is uniform throughout India and that was the situation now but in Vikas Institute of Pharmaceutical Sciences in addition to the program or curriculum fixed by the pharmacy council we conduct a tailor made packages that is training in industry aspect suppose if the students are interested in industry aspect because pharmacy is three areas of profession one is industry one is education one is R&D and hospital and clinical pharmacy suppose if the students are interested in industry, we train them for 40 days with industry experts. And 41st day, definitely the industry people will absorb these students who are gone and training under this. For this, we have appointed a consultancy called Pharma Training Institute in Bangalore, where the students will be trained in industry aspects. Another area, if the student is interested in clinical research, clinical trial, data analytics, bioinformatics, the latest developments, that is practice-oriented areas. We have engaged an agency called Clinisol from Hyderabad, where the students were trained in these aspects, in these areas, and they were sure of giving a placement. Why I am telling is, the curriculum what we are following is outdated curriculum. The technology is so fast. Today, the technology is tomorrow obsolete. The industry follows the latest technology, but still the institutions, we are using the old instruments and old methods, old technology based on the curriculum. Unless the students were trained with the latest developments, we cannot compete with the present scenario. That's what we believe. And we are having the special training, expert training in industry area and even practice area. That is one of the salient features of ECAS Institute of Pharmaceutical Sciences.
So the next question is, how do you strategize about the key programs and plans for the marketing and administration of a school?
Here again, one limitations all the institutions having in state of Andhra Pradesh is, the admissions are done by the government of Andhra Pradesh through common entrance test. Now earlier it is called MCET, now it is called EPSET. Engineering, pharmacy, agriculture, a common entrance test. And government is sending admissions of 85%. And managements are having only 50%. That was the limitation of role of the management in state of Andhra Pradesh. But this, how to have an edge over other institutions, even the government students or the management students, we have a strategic program or plan. Our students should have a better edge when compared with the students pursuing in other institutions or even university. Because these are the various programs we give them, because most of the students from the rural background and not having confidence with them, and having difficulty in speaking in English language. So in the beginning of the year, we start our program with a personality development program with one of our consultant, Dr. Jagannath Rao from Success Secrets from Bangalore. He will train the students in the first week of the joining of the program. And he will train the students and he will train them to speak in, communicate in the English language, whatever the language they can speak. Slowly, that students will be acquainted with that in their future program. And he will see that the student will come to the dais and speak boldly, because the most of the students, they never try to come and express their views if you offer them a stage or a dais. So this and time management, and also how to memorize your, how to strengthen your memory. These are some of the practice he will give during his training period. That is one advantage we have. And we organize almost every month one guest lecture with the expert from that particular field. Suppose he is an expert in manufacturing, he is expert in research and development, he is expert in drug discovery. We used to invite them, we used to have a workshop with that expert, and the student will be able to meet him personally, interact with him, exchange of views, exchange of ideas. That's what get the confidence in the student. That's what we are doing in our institution. and also training the students. I already mentioned you in industry perspective, training the students in practice perspective, and getting the scholarships for the poor and needy. Because our Vikas Institute of Pharmaceutical Sciences is one institution where one student will get full amount of fee from IPA Ramanbhai Patel Scholarship Foundation. All the 4 years, the student will be paid the scholarship. So whoever identified by the institution, that student will get. So far, more than 20 students got that benefit and they were well established in their life. And thanks to Ramanbhai Patel Foundation, that is a foundation of JDS Cadila company, whose son Pankaj Patel is there. He has identified our institution is one institution in India. He has identified 25 institutions in India. One is ours among the 25, where one student will get all the fee from this foundation, that is one. And also we have an advantage of international MOUs. We have MOUs with 4 universities, University of Arizona in US and University of Harvard, and also in Australia, Monash University and Repartition Hospital, where our student, if they want to pursue higher studies, we can guide them. And also recently we had a MOU with the Global Academic Leadership Forum, where the students want to go to, if the student want to go to UK universities, 50% chosen waiver off will be provided to them. That was one of the salient features with the recent MOU what we made on behalf of Vikas Institute of Pharmaceutical Sciences. These are some of the key programs, strategic programs, marketing, what we can say. Because I cannot say marketing, because education is not a marketing arena. It is the education, quality education we are giving to the students. That, and also definitely all these matters a lot. The students in Vikas Institute of Pharmaceutical Sciences feel that they have the edge over the other students pursuing in various places. And that confidence levels, definitely that's what I told you in the beginning, the confidence level and the communication level, we train them, which is the need of the day. That is the major success of our Vikas Institute.
Wonderful, sir. Wonderful. So, next question is, what do you think your roles and responsibilities to the university and the students are?
Yeah, because ours is not a university. It is a independent private institutions. But we are affiliated to university, Andhra University. And Andhra University, that is the second oldest university imparted pharmacy program in our country. And I am fortunate to say that I am alumni of Andhra University, where I studied my undergraduate and postgraduate. And being an alumni of the university, we organized several activities at university on behalf of Vikas Institute of Pharmaceutical Sciences, on behalf of Indian Pharmaceutical Association. We organized one of the biggest conventions, that is 68th Indian Pharmaceutical Congress in 2016 at Andhra University, where more than 10,000 student participants came, and the Honorable Chief Minister that time inaugurated that Congress, where all the 150 industry personnel, they came. And industry personnel, they opened their stalls, all the equipment, they trained the students how this equipment works, how the latest development taking place in the industry. And the university has got very good recognition by this, by organizing this seminar. Afterward, they organized a national science congress also. That's how we contributed for the recognition of university. That is one. As an affiliated college. And as an affiliated college, we all applied for the accreditation, NAC and NBA, where the credit also goes to the university. That is, that much role is limited to have our impact on the university. Whatever the best we are having, we are giving that impact. And students, they are the roles and responsibility to the students means they are also affiliated in our college, studying in our college. What are the facilities we are providing to the student? Definitely, once they go out, they should feel proud and say, I am the product of Andhra University. I am the student of Vikas Institute. That is our main goal and aim.
That's wonderful, sir. So, due to pandemic, what are the changes have you seen in terms of students aspiring for pharmaceutical sciences?
This 18 months, we all distracted with the new scenario, that is the COVID-19 pandemic. And almost every sector was destroyed and every personal life was destroyed during this 18 months. But I proudly say only two sectors were not affected. One is IT sector and one is pharma sector, if you go through. Now only the situation is coming to new normal, but still it is not at normal. All the other sectors, still they are suffering a lot, except IT sector and pharma sector. And this pharma sector, it is, I can say, blessing in disguise to the pharma sector and pharma professionals in the COVID-19 pandemic. People started recognizing the services of pharmacists. Earlier, society used to think pharmacy is a trade. The medical shop is also a trade. And no pharmacists, they don't know the pharmacists are working in hospitals. The pharmacists are working in railway hospitals, government hospitals, private hospitals. Nobody knows. But this pandemic has given the recognition to the pharmacist and pharmacy services. Because if you take the pharma industry, more than 2.5 lakh people worked and still working on shift basis. They made available the life-saving drugs to the society. If you take the statistical data, if the life-saving drugs are not available to the society, the number of deaths are around 4 lakh per year. The people dying with shortage of life-saving medicines. But if you take the death due to COVID-19 pandemic, till today it is around 2 lakhs. So if the life-saving drugs are not available to the society, the number of deaths will be made. That is the immense contribution made by the pharmacist. If you take pharmacy, all the medical shops, people call it as, there are 9.5 lakh pharmacists are there in our country. Right from the day one of lockdown, they started opening 24/7. They made the drugs available to the society. And also, they supplied the drugs to the geriatric patient. That means patient with old age. They never allowed the old age people to come out, take the medicine and expose it to the COVID-19. And around 60,000 pharmacists, they worked in various hospitals, railway hospital, government hospital. And 65,000 pharmacy teachers, they were engaged in online training of the students. And around 2,000 drug controllers, that is from Central Drug Control Department, State Drug Control Department, they have seen that there is no black marketing of the drugs. Even if one or two incidents are there, immediately they acted upon. And they have given fast-track permissions for manufacturing of sanitizers, masks, medical devices. And even if you take the vaccine, that it was approved on fast-track basis only. So all this made, okay, pharmacist is doing something different. He is doing this with services. That what the society has recognized. And thanks to Bharat Biotech Company, Krishna Yella, who came out with our indigenous vaccine, Covaxin. And thanks to Poonawalla, the Serum Institute, who has come out with the Covishield. These two proved our strength of pharmacy in the world. These two. And even Zydus Cadila is coming out with their product, and Dr. Reddy Labs also coming out with their product, and 2DG. So many products have come that India are the first in the world. And now the pharmacy, we are number 3 in the world. And we are exporting drugs to 160 countries. At present, our business worth is $80 billion, $60 billion, and expect to touch $80 billion by 2025. The internationally, the pharmacy, Indian pharmacy, is called as pharmacy of the world. That was the tagline given for pharma industry during this COVID-19. So all this made people not only nationally, internationally, to recognize the strength of our Indian pharma industry. Thanks to our Indian pharma industry personals who brought these laurels to our India. That's what I can say.
That's true, sir. I agree
and,
with you.
And now students also, they are looking at lot many opportunities, job opportunities in pharma industry, because many pharma industry closed earlier because bulk drug industry almost closed last 5 years. Now all the bulk drug industry, they, because of the bilateral relationships of India and China, they started opening now. And government is also sanctioned 8,000 crores to open 4 clusters of the bulk drugs at various places in our country, which gives wide opening of jobs for pharmacies. And internationally, WHO declared by the year 2025, there is a requirement of 20 million pharmacists as a workforce to the globe. If you take the number of pharmacists passing out in India, hardly it is around 4 lakhs. 20 million, that means around 2 crore workforce is required as per the WHO requirement. So a lot of opportunities are there. Now students are getting this information and now they are fascinated to pursue the programs like pharmacy or biotechnology, some different fields they are planning. Even engineering programs, those who are pursuing engineering also, they are trying to have something different along, instead of the routine or conventional system of the program. That's what they are looking. If you take as on now, I stay in Bangalore. The Karnataka State Engineering College is more than 70% of seats are vacant. The student aspirants are not there for engineering nowadays. Earlier, all the engineering institutions, they are full. Now, all the pharmacy institutions are full, and our even biotechnology, microbiology, and basic sciences, BSc and all, they are full now. Because there is a dearth of basic sciences right now. Earlier, last 5 years, every student, they want to go for engineering, they want to go for MBA, they want to go for architecture. Nobody there to pursue BSc and all. There is a dearth of basic sciences nowadays. And there is a good demand and great demand for basic sciences nowadays. So students are having a better view now. They are aspiring for pharmacy programs are increasing day by day. That's what I can say.
Yes, sir. So next question is, what would you like people to know about your institution that they may not know?
People, those who want to admit their children, they think, okay, B pharmacy is our pharmacy programs are there available right from after plus two. First, they will think, okay, any college is same, because if they go for the entrance, okay, whether you will get in Vikas Institute or you will get in some X Institute, BPharm is BPharm. But they don't know what are the advantages. And they will come to know the information through some of their friends or the senior students or through mouth-to-mouth publicity. If somebody says, okay, go to Vikas, it is a good institute, then they will come here first. But they don't know what are the advantages if they admit their children in this institution. First, they will ask, is there any placement? Is there any placement? See, placement is not the criteria for the quality education. And pharmacy, very few industries will come to the colleges for placement. And none of the multinational company will come to any institution for placement. Though people say we are having placement and all, it is wrong. We are having placement through IPA portal, because Vikas Institute of Pharmaceutical Sciences is having a local branch of Indian Pharmaceutical Association. which bagged 3 times best local branch award. And the placements will be offered through Indian Pharmaceutical Association if the student is pursuing his degree or postgraduate in Vikar. And we have international students, more than 100 international students. We have students from Iran, students from Iraq, students from Singapore, students from Nepal, students from Sudan. Because the education in those countries are very expensive. It is around 20 lakhs per year they have to shell down or more. Here, within 20 lakh, they will complete their PharmD program. Within 5 to 6 lakh, they will complete their BPharm program. And most of the parents, they are not witnessing what is happening in this institution and they are joining their children in the neighboring states. Like some reputed colleges will be there, some Manipal is there, in Chennai some Ramachandra is there, in Bangalore some Dayanand Sagar or MS Ramya College, the names are there. So people, they started preferring those colleges, but the same quality of education, the same facility, and I can say still we have the more facility than them. The Vikas Institute of Pharmaceutical Sciences is the having biggest building, independent building for pharmacy in our country. We have 1,45,000 square feet building, which is highest when compared with any top university in India, independent university. And highly qualified, more than 10 PhDs are there. And national awardees are there as a PhD. And we have more than 2 crore projects, industrial projects, we are offering, conducting there in our campus, training the students. And we have CERP project of DST, Department of Science and Technology, 1 crore project we are running right now. These are the facilities we have. And what I initially told you, personality development program, we are the first to conduct this type of program. And MOU with international universities, those who want to pursue higher studies with scholarship, we are the first to implement this program. These are some of the things people should know. No need to go away for higher, better quality education. The same quality education will be provided here with 100% job assistance. That's what I can say. So none of our students are vacant now. As soon as is in final year, completion of final year exam, all were placed. And those who want to go abroad, recently last week, 4 students left to United States for pursuing their higher studies. That was the strength.
Wonderful, sir, wonderful. And I wish that College Duniya will help you to provide a platform where people can know about Vikas Institute and get the most authentic information. So next question is, what are the roles of online and digital medium in promotion of your institution?
Yeah, because of this pandemic, people are talking about this online and digital mode of instruction. But this we started four years back. The online module of training and digital module of learning. Why means, with this, we have engaged an agency called V Medulife from Pune, who has done a wonderful platform, who has given us a wonderful platform. We called it as ILMS, Institute Learning Management System. There was a portal in this V Medulife. And through this portal, we invite the experts from abroad, because I have, being a national president of Indian Pharmaceutical Association, I have a good contact with many industry MDs, experts, and the leaders in the profession of pharmacy, not only nationally, but internationally. I used to invite the experts online, and I used to engage the students, listen to them, because how the student can become a leader? By listening to the leaders, he will become the leader. That's what I believe. So he will share his experiences, how he developed the industry, and also the latest development taking place. Now people are talking about the tablet capsules, whatever we are available in the market. But in due course, within the 5 years of down the line of 5 years, all the technology will go. The 3D technology is coming. The 3D technology means the coating will be given as per your body needs. They will not give, suppose if you take now in COVID, Dolo 650 is prescribed for everybody. But your body may not require 650. My body may not require 650. If your body require 500 mg, that mg 500 only, it will be given by 3D coating and they will be given. Because it is to avoid unnecessary use of medication. Because the medicine, when you use as a medicine, it is works as a medicine. If you use in excess, it is a poison, no doubt in it. That's these type of technologies are coming in future, where our experts will train the students. This is the area coming in future, because it was not covered in curriculum. Like that, we started using this earlier. Now, because of COVID-19 pandemic, the university and UGC authorities, they made it compulsory to have online platform. So we are using the same platform. And even practicals also, we developed a module, stimulation modules of teaching the students, where our university also followed the same thing. Now they asked us to conduct sessionals online and even practicals online. It is going to happen this week. That's how we train our students well in advance. We equip ourselves in case of extraordinary circumstances like this COVID-19. We are fully equipped to conduct online classes on digital mode of education, both theory and practicals.
That's wonderful, sir. So the next question is, what is Vikas Institute of Pharmaceutical Sciences' greatest strength?
Greatest strength is the director himself is a national president of Indian Pharmaceutical Association and president of Southeast Asian region of WHO. Our students feel proud for that. That is one. And major strength, I can say, is the staff. The staff what we have, because now recently due to COVID-19, I lost my teacher, my guru, my mentor as a professor, a direct research director of my institution, Professor KPR Chaudhary, who is an awardee of Chief Minister Awardee. And Professor D. Satyanarayana, who is the founder of Mangalore College, which is a reputed college now. And more than 10 PhDs we are having, which is highest when compared with any institution in our area. I cannot say it is in India, in our area. And the attitude of the staff and management, we have empathetic attitude, no sympathetic attitude. And students are, they will feel free to contact either staff or management at any point of time. And we targeted the students with low caliber and not up to the mark to pursue their studies. And mentorship program was given to each and every staff. Each and every staff will act as a mentors for 4 to 5 week students. Empathetic attitude of our staff, and the students are free to contact at any point of time, either the teachers or the management, and they are free to express their grievances. And mentoring of weak students in problem-based learning and evidence-based learning, that is the success, that is the strength of ECAS. So I am not bothered of the rank holders. Suppose you say, sir, we got university first rank, university second rank. I used to ask, what is the percentage of our institution? I want the weak student also to pass. So that efforts are important for me, because nowadays the rank is not the criteria. When you go for the interview, the employee is looking at what capacity the duty assigned can be done by this person. They are not looking whether you are a gold medalist or rank holder, whether he can discharge, deliver the goods assigned to him or not. What is his sincerity, what is his honesty? That is the main criteria. Because these ranks and gold medals are required if you are pursuing, going, targeting research, where your intellectual property rights comes to into picture. Otherwise, the student sincerity and honesty, that's what we try to guide the students with mentoring. And placements, no doubt in it, because once the student, if you go to the interview, if you say, I am from VIPS, our student proudly call it as VIPS, VIPS, MICAS Institute of Pharmaceutical Sciences. The industry people, they know, they were well trained in the industry aspects, and immediately they will ask, okay, Baba, what is the salary you are expecting? Even I used to advise the student, if the student don't join for 10,000, 15,000, you tell directly, yes, I was trained like this. I have this confidence. I was exposed to so many instruments. My minimum salary requirement should be 25,000. I have seen so many people. First, they join for 8,000, 10,000 rupees. And they think that afterward, they will get the benefit after getting 1 year of experience. But our students will not join that way. And that is the confidence we give to the students. They will demand and they will command. That's all.
Wow, wow, wonderful, sir. Sir, are there any suggestions you would like to give to the current youth and aspiring students?
Yeah, no doubt in it, because the youth, they are the power of the nation. They are the future of our country. And what I observed is, nowadays, I have come across almost all the states in our country. They are very strong in emotions, very strong in emotions, weak in judgments. If something goes wrong, they are not in a position to tolerate it. That's why there is a lot of commitment of suicides and all these things are happening at various places. And it is not the solution. A failure, definitely failure is your first step of success. That should be inculcated in the minds of the youth. If a simple failure may not be the solution, suicide may not be the solution, or depression may not be the solution. Yes, you have to fight. That colleges should inculcate that type of habit during the student days. Because now the institutions also, there was a mistake. What they were telling, okay, itna paisa nahi, okay, I got this much of money. You teach them whether he pass or fail, why should I bother? Whether he succeed or not succeed, why should I bother? As soon as I get my salary, management thing, as soon as I get my donation amount or fees amount, whatever maybe, that should not be. Because you should have your impact, because the role you play is going to be major in molding a student of his own career. You should have that type of impact on the student. Even students also will change that time. Because up to 10th standard, the way up to plus two, the way they studied, it is something different. When they join professional courses, the methodology is different, the way they are exposed to education is different. So we have to educate the student, guide the student. Because in my college, I will tell you, when I started the institution in the year 2008, but my basic earlier for 25 years, I was there in Bangalore, the state of Karnataka, where the exact teaching methodology is different. When I exposed to these students of first year, they are fully by-harding the things and writing. If they give you a piece of paper, they will write everything. That's why 90% above, 94% above, 95% results are coming, marks are coming. When you ask them a question, they are not in a position to answer. If you give a piece of paper, they will write. So this I observed in the beginning. Oh, they are not applying their critical thinking, what we call it as a critical thinking, which is required to settle in their future. But because of the parents are the main culprits, I can say here. They want the children to score 95%, 98%. That is one. And next, they will compare with the neighboring children. See, that girl got 95, this boy got 96. We have to see the capacity of our children. Now, parents are imposing their ideas on the student. Yeah, you have to become doctor, you have to become engineer, you have to become this. And comparatively, they will compare. Or that boy has gone to America, you also has to go to America. But you have to see the strength of your boy, where he is interested. He is not interested, but he joined the program, definitely he will be a failure. That student should come out of it. They should tell boldly, yes, this is not my area. This is my area. I will be succeeded if I admitted I joined this area. That should be, they should be bold enough to say. That's what I want to advise. And this only the strong in judgment, weak in judgment, the strong in emotion, you have to come out of that particularly, definitely you will have a beautiful future and a wonderful life in the future. That's what I can say.
Thank you so much, sir. I'm sure students will be empowered and understand what message you are trying to give us. Thank you so much, sir.